In this video, we'll show you how to demagnetize a watch with three different types of demagnetizers, and how to test for a magnetized watch. If you have a watch that is running more than a minute fast per day, it's likely it has been magnetized. This watch here is magnetized. We'll use a timegrapher to check how it's doing. If you don't know what a timegrapher does, we have a video on it. Let's put it on a timegrapher and see how it's doing. As you can see, the reading is pretty wild. You can see two common signs of magnetism, which are low amplitude and extremely high rate. This is not definitive proof though, as other factors can be causing it to run fast as well. We'll need to test for magnetism. There are two ways. The first method can be done with a compass. Wave the watch above a compass. A magnetized watch will significantly deflect a needle. This is not a very accurate test, as any ferrous metal can deflect the needle, so we are watching for significant deflection as a sign of magnetism. If you don't have a compass on hand, you can use the magnetic field sensor in your phone. Download Lepsy on iPhone or any Gauss meter app on Android. If the reading fluctuates a lot when the watch is passed over the phone, the watch is magnetized. Now we know for sure that the watch is magnetized. We'll fix this by using a demagnetizer. Here we have three types of demagnetizers, ranging from very cheap to pretty expensive. The first one is a cheap, made in China demagnetizer. Place the watch face up on the box. Hold down the red button, then slowly lift the watch from the box in around 5 seconds. Essentially, you are dragging the watch through a magnetic field of decaying strength and changing orientations, so the magnetism on the watch is disrupted, and thus demagnetizing the watch. Let's check if the watch is still magnetized. Seems like there's some left. So I'll do a few more passes on this demagnetizer. As you can see, the demagnetizing power isn't that great with this device, so it is sometimes used only on tools and components. Next up is this kind with a hole in the middle. This costs a bit more than the last one, and the demagnetizing power is much better. We think this offers the best value for money out of these three demagnetizers. It works in a similar way. You hold down the button, put the watch into the hole slowly, and slowly take it out. One or two passes will do. If you want to go fancy and you have the money to do so, this piece of German engineering here will do the trick. It's as simple as this. That's it. Now let's see how the watch is doing after the process. The readings are back to normal, and the watch is back to its usual accuracy. I might want to regulate it to improve its accuracy later, but for now, this is good enough. So that's how you demagnetize a watch. We've included links to the three demagnetizers used in this video down below. Comment on your experience fixing a magnetized watch. We'd love to hear your story. Thanks for watching. Remember to like and subscribe for more watchmaking tutorials and tips.